Earlier this year, bags of blood went on sale on the black market, claiming to be from recovered COVID-19 patients. They were being marketed as a source of lifelong immunity from the virus. Those sales are obviously dodgy. But harvesting somebody's blood for its ability to fight coronavirus and injecting it into another, well, that's happening across the world. So, how much hope can we have in blood? The very first Nobel Prize for Medicine in 1901 went to this guy, Emil von Behring. Emil von Behring injected a toxin into horses, which made them produce antibodies in their blood to fight diphtheria disease. He then took that blood, purified it, and transferred it into humans to prevent and cure the deadly infection. Blood transfusion was also used to fight the Spanish flu pandemic in 1918, scarlet fever in the 1920s, and even today, blood plasma injections are widely used. They're especially useful for people who can't be vaccinated from chickenpox or measles, or for COVID-19, where we don't have a vaccine yet. So, how does it work? If you've recovered from COVID-19, your body has developed natural defences against it. Those defences live in your blood. They're the antibodies. They live in the plasma, and in case you didn't already know, plasma's actually yellow. The idea is you donate your plasma at a regular blood bank and then they give it to a COVID-19 patient, sharing your body's defences with them. It's actually kind of lovely. The words you'll be hearing thrown around today are convalescent plasma, roughly translating to the plasma of a recovered person.
So the aim of the treatment is to see if we can help patients recover faster from the infection.
Seems pretty straightforward, right? But will convalescent plasma be effective against COVID-19? In the US, 20,000 coronavirus patients have received convalescent plasma, but that was part of an emergency access program to experimental therapies, not a clinical trial setting, which means it was measured for its safety, but not its effectiveness. Lifeblood Australia is trying to go one step further. They've been collecting blood from recovered COVID patients since May, and three clinical trials are now underway here. One gives plasma to COVID patients in hospital, another to more severe patients in ICU. And a third takes a bunch of different people's plasma, extracts the antibodies altogether, and then mixes them into some kind of immunity cocktail. Associate Professor Zoe McQuilton is leading the two hospital trials. She'll be looking for evidence of fewer deaths, as well as fewer and shorter ICU stays.
If that looks like that is much lower in the group that received convalescent plasma, then we would determine that it was effective.
The thing is, unlike a drug whose ingredients can be measured and controlled, antibodies vary from person to person, which means effectiveness could also vary. So, if these treatments work, would we still need a vaccine? The short answer, yes. A vaccine carries a part of the actual virus that wakes up your immune system, makes it ring the alarm bells, and then creates its own antibodies. That's called active immunity. A plasma transfusion is passive, which means the body isn't creating its own antibodies, it's borrowing them from someone else. The catch is, with borrowed antibodies,
it wouldn't be lasting immunity, it would only be very short-term immunity.
An effective vaccine will give you that lifelong immunity. And to lend immunity using plasma, someone still has to get infected with COVID-19 first, which means it's feasible for the US or Brazil where cases are in the millions, but not for every other country. But until a vaccine does arrive, plasma treatment could still prove the difference between life and death. And for that, it's worth exploring.
Hey, if you enjoyed that, make sure you subscribe to The Feed's YouTube channel.
And you can watch these videos here. See you next time.